So why not get a free armor set? This armor set has tiers. You can unlock all the essential components for 60 challenges. Then goes to tier 2 and upwards. Yeah. This is nice. If you want to see the armor set, I have it here because I completed, I had all the tiers. So here is the armor set for Trials of the Ancestors. Looks like this. This is with maximum tiers capable. Let's equip it at the moment. Okay, so I have it here. One moment, I need to disable all these shiny graphics. I need to remove my wand and my shield. I'm doing some experiments with this shield. Please do not this. If you're going to do this build, do it as I made it in the video. You know, I like to experiment with items, but you will have problems if you equip this one. Okay, now let's look at the cosmetics. Here is the body armor. And here are the tiers. When you unlock 16 challenges, you will look like this. So you know from the start. You will look like this. More challenges you complete, you have access to more tiers. Okay, so it will look like this. And eventually, if you do 38, you will look like this. To be honest, I have mixed opinions about this body armor.
Yeah.
I like the one that we got in Crucible because it has also vocal lines, which is nice. It has a strange interaction when you pick Chaos or Valorbs, Velchaos Orbs, when you use crafting bench or open the map device, which is nice. But this one is pretty simple. You know, it has just an aura effect. It's nothing special. For me, at least, I don't like so much this one. But if you already did some challenges, because if you open the H panel, you will see you have this some. Let's explore them one by one. And maybe you want to get more than 60 challenges. And now I will explain you how to do everything here the easiest way possible. First, I need to say one more thing, because some of you, maybe you are new players. Yeah. So when you do challenges, you'll get some numbers. Look, before the name, so it's the name, there is the guild tag if you're in a guild, then it's the name, your character name. So here these numbers represent how many challenges that person completed. Look, this is going to global chat. As you can see, there is a number. Okay, so this guy completed 38 challenges, 38 challenges. This is useful because some of you don't know what these numbers represent. Yeah. So you can see how much invested is that character into the league, or maybe he just joined the league. Okay, now let's explore these challenges. Let's go somewhere else because here I have a lot of effects. Yeah, let's look. So beginner's basic, this one everyone will complete because it's very easy and it's mandatory. You will need to defeat an act boss, self-explanatory, nothing to talk here. Here you will need just to do the league mechanic. You will do the arenas and you will complete naturally, very easy. In the first fight you will complete it. Here it's every league, they have a peddler's produce recipe which will require certain vendor recipes. This many of you don't know, even veteran players don't know, because some of the recipes are weird and we'll never make them. But to complete the challenge, you need to do them. This is very easy to do. Look here. You go on Google and you just write Peddler's Produce and Trials of the Ancestors. And you open the first links. And you have here the recipes. Yeah, that is very easy. Here I will give you a tip, which these guys do not say. So, to get your bases for these recipes, you will use your stash tabs to get, the basic currency, like Orb of Fusing, stuff like that. But to get your bases, so you will use trade website, but you can go to Gwen and go gamble for items and you buy your bases here. For example, says an amulet, you buy amulet here. Says a rustic sash, you buy your rustic sash here. It's very fast, so you don't do a lot of trade. This is a secret. You can also buy your bases from Rogue. So you deal items and you refresh and you buy whatever you need. Yeah, this is a good tip. Now let's check the others. Okay, Peddler's Produce, very easy to find. You can complete this in under 10 minutes, under 5 minutes. Act Adversaries. This you'll complete naturally as you progress to the campaign. Deadly Deeds. This you'll complete naturally. Even in the campaign, you'll find Strongboxes, Abysses, Smuggler Caches. Very easy to complete. This again, you need to do the League Mechanic, which is the Bullshit Arena. You do the Bullshit Arena and the more you play, you will complete this. Next one, Act Adversaries. This is again the campaign. you need to finish the campaign so you can reach the end game, so you'll complete this. As you can see, you already completed 5 or 4, so why not go for 16? This is my advice. Every league, GGG makes it so that the first 16 challenges are casual friendly. So maybe you don't have a lot of time to play, you know, maybe you have a job, maybe your time is very limited. That's why they thought on this and they made the first 16 challenges very accessible, so everyone can do them. Now let's explore. I want to reach some harder challenges. Maybe some of you want to go above 16, you know. Also, when you get 40 challenges, you will receive a special totem. So these are the totems that you get for 40 challenges. Now I spread them out in my hideout. I don't know, one here, one here, two there. This is from this league. They are pretty similar. You know, one here, you got the idea. Yeah, let's go back here. These are the side quests from the campaign. So if you do all quests while doing the campaign, you will also get this challenge. Very easy. These ones. Some of these challenges can be completed very fast using memories. As you will see, for the essence ones, you will go on trade website and you will buy this one. I already have it here selected. Enhanced memory of crystal prisons. If you run this memory multiple times, you will get this completed very fast. But be aware, you need a strong build. You need a strong build because essences can be a pain, especially in tier, in level 83 or higher areas. Divine dominance. This is very easy. Complete each of the following when you have a shrine of you. So basically what you need to do, you go here on your atlas and you will set up with shrines. So you'll take all the shrine nodes. This will guarantee shrines in your maps. Then you do what requested. So you'll put shrine and harbinger and you will defeat the boss. Shrine and breach until you get a breach lord. Shrine and legion content until you get a general. Very easy. Okay, let's see here. Complete each of the following breach content. Again, this one can be completed very easy without respecting your atlas by using this one's memories. Yeah, I think it's Nico. You see, there are multiple ones. Nico's memory of demonic onslaught, area contest, additional large bridge hands. You will use memories. Let's see here. Again, you do the bullshit arena and eventually you will complete this. Nothing special. Again, here you respect your atlas into harbingers and you do maps over and over and you'll complete this naturally. It's not hard. Same with legion. You respect your atlas into legion content. Do maps over and over and you'll complete this. Same with delirium. Same with ritual. Let me read. Yeah, nothing special. This one is a bitch. This challenge is a bitch challenge. So I tried to do this. It was my last challenge before I went to 44. So I will explain you like this. Let's open the bullshit arena. So we need to take a coin. Okay, we go straight to the bullshit arena. Okay, let's go to Navali area. Okay, so I'll explain what you need to do here. After you take some points, you will talk with these guys and you'll buy the field idols. The problem is you don't have access to all the required field idols here. I don't know why. So I think it's based on rank, because at the moment I have rank above 700. What I did here, I logged in on my alt character, which starts at around at lower rank. You have access to multiple idols, but still is not enough. So I ask in my guild. I go in my guild. Hey boys, do you have idols? And I made a screenshot with the idols that I'm missing, and they helped me. Okay, they helped me because these idols are randomly spawned. I don't know. You won't have access to everyone. So you can ask in trade channels or global channels or pay someone that has these specific idols. Yeah, this is how you do it. Now let's look here. This is very easy. Okay, so I was saying this one is very easy. You will do it naturally as you unlock your ascendancy points. Divine Destiny. Again, you do your maps, you find divination cards. When you have multiple ones, this is how I like to do it. I stash everything in my divination card tab. When I reach full stacks, I take everything out and I turn it to Navali. I turn it to Lily. And you will complete this naturally, nothing special. Very easy to complete, it's an easy one. Pedal Produce 2, again. Here are vendor receives that are more complex. For the Exaltis Shard receive, you will do... I did it with Shaper maps. You can do any of these Conqueror maps. I did it with Shaper maps. At the end, the final boss will drop some influence items. And you need to vendor like this, a full set of items. So you will pick up a shield, a wand or a one-handed weapon, a helmet, a body armor, rings, amulets, belt, gloves and boots with influence from Shaper. You will vendor them and you will get exalted shards. That's how you complete it. If you run multiple Shaper maps and let's say you don't find an amulet and a belt, don't worry. You can go on trade website and buy the missing pieces. Make sure the item level for this is above 81. Yeah. Crucial construction. This is again very easy. You take a normal base, okay, and you start applying all this currency. The only problem that I can see here is a divine orb. Maybe for some player hurts, you know, to apply a divine orb, but it does not have to be a rare one. Let's say maybe you have an unique item and you want to reroll it. You can do that. Maybe you have a Watcher's Eye. Let's see, you bought a Watcher's Eye and it has shit rolls. You can try your luck while doing this challenge. You will apply a Divine Orb on that. Yeah, very easy to do. The tattoos are very easy also. You go on trade website and you buy what you're missing. You know, you just focus on one node. This will be your experimental node. As you do the bullshit arena, you'll have access to tattoos. And you start applying them until you finish the challenge. Very easy. Let's see, here it's about the unique maps. Okay, so you need to do them. Some of them are problematic because they are very rare and expensive, but I'll teach you how to do it. You go on TFT Discord and you have here challenges why to buy or want to sell. And you first you look here what people are selling. Yeah, if you need something from this list, for example this one, the Exalted Shard. If you're too lazy to collect all the items, you can contact this guy, say, boss, give me the recipe. Very easy. Also, this is a good method to make extra money. So let's say you're doing Shaper Guardians, okay? You put all your Shaper influenced items in another tab, and when you have a full set, you go here and you sell it for one divine to diviners. You'll be surprised how many private messages you got. The matter of fact, this guy just edited his topic because he sold his set. So you can make nice profit just by farming Shaper Guardians. I prefer Shapers. There are multiple reasons for this. I talk in other videos because the amulets can be very expensive. Same with the boots. Yeah. Also, if you do simulacrums, for example, you can post here your services and you get extra money on top. Very nice. Or you can write here. Just write what challenges you need and people will contact you. So use TFT Discord a lot. For challenges, I mean. Because the one with the problems, it's this one, where it is. Vinktar Square can be a problem for some of you. And also it's Doriani Machinarium. This is pretty expensive. So if you go on trade website, we refresh this. And we put Doriani's Machinarium. Okay. You will see it's expensive, more than two diviners. And will get even more expensive as time passes by because people need it for challenges. Yeah. This one is very hard. I will say line now because maybe you don't have a good build for this. Sanctums can be very hard on specific builds and you need to complete the sanctum while having a unique relic active. Yeah. So this it's I will put it in hard category. Many players won't be able to do this alone. Maybe you can ask for help or go. But this will give you headaches. So this one is the first really hard one. Corrupt. This is again very easy. You level gems to 20 and you apply Val Orbs. You know, to get a Val Temple map, it's again very easy. You go to your map tabs. You take uncorrupted maps. Maybe we get it now. Okay, let's take some uncorrupted. I'll show you how to get Val Temple map very easy. I will also juice them. And I don't want to spend a lot of time. Let's put like this. Few sectant. I'll put some alchemy orb on there. Okay. If it's tier 16 map and you apply a Val Orb, it has a low chance to turn up into Val Temple map. Let's see. Very low chance. You will get it eventually. This is how you do it. Oh, this is nice. I will run it. Okay. For White Socket again. You go take some unique items and you click Val Orbs. One of the Val corruptions is gives white sockets. No problem here. Cross contamination. Defeat a Brishlo White Delirious. You will apply a Delirium Orb. Let's say you take a random orb. When you apply this on a map, it will give Delirious status. So to get a delirium status, you will apply this delirium orb. You don't need to take those points. Defeat a possessed mob boss while in a ritual. Again, this is very easy. You need to play with your Atlas skill points. So first of all, you will need to have to take the ritual notes. So you'll have ritual, and eventually, from time to time, you will have the ritual altars at the map boss, and you complete it very easy. This one, banish ancestor totems. This is again self-explanatory. As you do the league mechanic, which is the ancestor arena, you will banish all the totems. The more you do, the better. It's not hard, maestro mastery. This one is very hard. So it's the second hard challenge, yeah? This one I did it by mistake. You know, I just ran Katarina. So the Syndicate Mastering is Katarina for Junjun. I just killed Katarina and at the end I noticed that I completed this challenge. Don't ask me how, I didn't even try this to complete it, boys. But I'll show you how to complete this very easy. Again, you go here and you look for people because they are selling them. Look. Some people are selling for the Sanctum one. Look, this is extremely expensive. I think I'll do this service. And this is a nice business idea, boys. So if you do Sanctums already, you can offer Sanctum services here. Look, carries them. This guy got rich. So he charges 30 diviners for Sanctum, which Sanctums you do naturally. So if you have a strong build and you already do Sanctums, offer Sanctum services on TFT and you'll be rich. Trust me, because last league I did Crucible services for the Forge and I overpaid them like 20 diviners and they paid. So people will really contact you. This guy got rich by doing Sanctum services. Keep in mind. So yeah, you can do this very easy on TFT Discord because people, this is how I do Aul, for example. This is very easy, bestiary boss, but Aul, I went off TFT Discord and people were selling it. I paid 2 diviners for the challenge. Reverse revenge ritual. Again, here you will complete them naturally without even knowing. You do your maps and at the end you notice that you completed. One moment. Okay. Usually you need a build which has burst of damage. Okay, I have Shrapnel Ballista, my main setup. They can destroy everything in under 1 second. So you destroy them so fast that they will complete the challenges. Again, if you cannot complete some of them, go on TFD Discord and you buy these challenges. Core Mechanica. Again, this will you will complete them naturally. You will notice progress as you play maps. Complete 6 iPhone. Okay, this is again very easy. You need to have some memories. You will drop memories in your maps, you see, and you run them. Look, for example, Incursion. You look in the list, you have the Incursion. You take this memory of Incursion, maybe Alva's memory of this Incursion, you complete it, and you will have very easy to do. Neverending Nirvana. This is very hard. This is the third very hard challenge. Look here. You need to defeat the final round while you have no Karui warriors or field items. Basically, when you're alone versus the whole army. And this is very hard because some of those bitches will go behind your lines and capture your totem. Very hard. I will explain how to do it. At the moment I'm 700 or more ranking. And the fights, if I'm going to do, this is impossible in that ranking. You need to do it at low rank. The lowest rank possible is 200. So you need to contact someone that already is at low rank, around 200. And you will pay him, you know, like 5 divine, 3 divine orbs. And you pay him to have access at the last tournament boss. And you will do most of the things. So he will defend the base or run in circles like a bitch. And you will kill everything very easy. Because the lower the rank is, the easier it is to complete the arena. So you need to contact a friend or find someone on TFT Discord or in the trade channel that is willing to invite you. Because in this arena, you can play in multiple guys. Yeah, ideally, you want to play in 2 or 3 guys and you finish this challenge. Yeah, the rest are easy. Oh, here it's again very easy. You will put on your maps altars, and when you click them and you take them, this will give progress. Also, you have for scarabs, sextant, you will get it naturally. Nothing to talk about here. As you do maps, you will get progression here. Compassing the following maps. Okay, this here you need to have a strong build. It's actually pretty easy. If you have a strong build, it's pretty easy. What you will take here, you will take 5 delirium orbs. Let's take like this. You will take, let's read again. Yeah. So you need to take any of these maps. I prefer the Shaper Guardian maps because they have a straight layout. So let's here take a Shaper Guardian map. Minotaur, which you need to dodge his burrowed attack because he will one shot you. You place 5 of this, so it's 100% delirious. Keep in mind, this will make it extremely hard, so you need to have an extreme build or call for help. You can call me if you want, you know, because I'm your man for this. Maybe you want to join my guild because I have 50 spots opened. Yeah. Okay, boys, now let's look here. What is 4 gilded scarabs and at least 100 item quantity. So let's get the quantity right. We'll put some chisels. Okay, so we roll it until we have 100, above 100 quantity. You will get it eventually. Let's try again. 98. Fuck this shit, man. This guy will bring me more Chaos Orbs, you know. He knows that I'm rerolling maps with Chaos Orbs, and he came to give me more. Take your jewel. You see, he noticed that I'm rerolling my map. He came to help me. Look, I got it. Okay, the problem is, look here, players cannot regenerate life. Okay, you need a really strong build. I can do it on my Shrapnel Ballista guy. So now, and the last thing you need to do, you need to put on fragments and you need to take Gilded Scarabs. Take them not so random, because you don't want to take Torment Scarabs or the map boss, which is already very just. It gets possessed, you don't want that shit. So you need to take Scarabs that don't do nothing. Maybe Reliquary, maybe Divination Scarabs. You want to take Cartography, something that does not affect the last boss or the monsters. Expedition and you skip it. You got the idea. Maybe Blight Encounter. Okay, you have 4, you put your map device and you run this shit. You need a strong build or you need to contact me or someone for help. Yeah? And this is how you do it. Insane Invitation. This is extremely easy. Basically, you will do this. This is special Maven Invitation. You can fight them here. Also these ones. And you need to have quantity above 80, which is very easy to do. Also, if you run this, usually you want quantity, so you get more items. The only reason you don't want quantity is on these special invitations, because it does not affect the... So, example, if I put quantity on this, it will not give me better chance for Assage of the Stars, or Forbidden Flesh Jewels, or Nimis Ring. That's why I like to run them clean, because quantity only makes the fight harder. But for this challenge, you will apply it. Look, 80. 80 or more. This is how you do it. Let's look, because we have few more. Unlock everything. This is self-explanatory, boys. You need to unlock everything here. Very easy to do. Again, at lower ranking, at least rank... Okay, so after rank 300, you need to do this. If you have a strong build, you'll complete them naturally. Nobody likes to use field items. Sometimes you won't die. You see, without dying, doing it. It's very easy. Nothing special here. This is again very easy to do. You get an expedition boss or shabby you need to use. Let me see if I have. Now you need a sacred blossom for a shabby. For the Izaro you need to put a special invite. Yeah, nothing special. If you can go on TFT Discord, people are offering services for this. Very easy, very cheap also. Yeah, nothing special. Abyss Leech. In your maps, if you do abysses, you will find abyssal deaths and you can kill the leech. Here for the expedition, you will find bosses if you do expedition logbooks. This is not hard. Not hard. This can be tricky, you know. I completed some of them without even trying, you know. You do the boss and then you see you did the challenge. Okay, this is easy. If you cannot do them, let's say you try to do Jupiter Vaults and you keep being hit by tentacles, you can go on TFT Discard and you buy it. Because you need skill for them. Look here. The Shaper without being hit from non-basic attack skill. So you need to be very good at this. Okay, you need some Path of Exile experience. But if you cannot do it, don't worry. You got your disket, you buy it. Okay. This one is very easy actually. To get level 100, you do 5 ways. It's the easiest of all, but you need to have money. You know, money makes the world go round. So the more divine orbs you have, the better for completing these challenges. This is again very easy. Maybe you will put this in your Atlas setup. This will give you an improved labyrinth trial for those Gift of the Goddess special invites, which sell very good, and you also get the progress towards this. Also, there are val-sided areas. You will enter, you'll complete very easy. 50 is not a lot. It's the easiest one. I think this is more easy than this, level 100. Red tier maps with 8 modifiers. Maps with 8 modifiers are this one. You can press and hold Alt and you count the modifiers. As you can see, this has 8 modifiers. Usually, if quantity is above 100, means it has 8 modifiers. Also, you have Val Temple maps, which can have 8 modifiers, very easy to complete. And this is extremely easy. If you do the bullshit arena, you will complete this naturally. You press on your coin and you do arena after arena, you know, until you get bored and you say it's a bad mechanic. Boys, I hope this was useful to you. My advice is, if you're a casual player and you don't have time to play, go for 16 challenges. Have a great day, boys. Good luck.